I get it. You feel like it's too pricey, a headache to deal with, and not worth it. You deserve something better and better. We're on a mission to get everyone the health coverage they deserve. Her. These two. And definitely them. Nice. Need an affordable plan with a network of local doctors you trust? Ambetter's got that and more. That's why we're America's number one marketplace health insurance brand. Ambetter, on a mission for better.
Did you know some of your detergent's fragrance disappears in the dryer? Downy InWash scent boosters survive the washer and dryer for freshness that lasts 6 times longer than detergent alone. Release freshness with every touch with Downy InWash scent boosters.
Joining us Tuesday, legendary rapper Ice Cube shares new music from his supergroup Mount Westmore. Tuesday at 6 a.m. on the KTLA 5 Morning News.
Good morning, I'm Frank Beckley. This hour, the LAPD will give an update on its investigation into a sexual assault at a popular local hiking trail. We're going to share those details just ahead.
I'm Erin Myers in Long Beach. A woman held at gunpoint during a home invasion robbery. Her children were home at the time. All of the latest coming up.
I'm Eric Spillman. Governor Newsom calls state lawmakers into a special session at noon today to talk about penalizing oil companies for high gas prices. I'll have the latest.
Good morning, I'm Jessica Holmes. Dodgers just reached a deal to keep one of their veteran pitchers for one more year and a whole lot of money. We'll tell you about it.
Almost everyone in L.A. remembers the Mark and Brian show. Remember the Mark and Brian show? It was legendary. Well, he was one half of the most iconic radio show to ever grace the Los Angeles airwaves. Mark Thompson from Fox, he was a weatherman and now he's a writer. We will have him live, talk all about it. That's coming up in the Entertainment Report. Stay tuned.
Good Monday morning, TGIM. I'm Kirk Hawkins filling in for Mark Kriske, who would remind you to have a great Monday ahead. The weather, spectacular. Partly cloudy skies today, slightly warmer, although we are seeing temperatures below normal. This could be the warmest day of the week. 64 along the coast, 63 downtown LA, 60 in the San Fernando Valley. A bit breezy at times, in particular in the Inland Empire, the high desert, where we're seeing temperatures in the mid-50s to around 60 degrees. More details on another storm arriving as early as tomorrow. Jessica, now back to you.
Kirk, thank you. Happening now, the LAPD is giving an update on their investigation into a woman who was sexually assaulted while on a hike. This is a live picture from the West Valley Community Police Station in Reseda. The victim was hiking the Canyon Back Trail in the hills above Encino on November 21st when she was attacked. The suspect approached her from behind and then took her into a secluded area where he assaulted her. The suspect is being described as someone in his 30s with a 2-inch scar on his right forearm. Arjean Kang, we're going to have a live report from him coming up at 10:30.
To this developing news in Long Beach, a mother held at gunpoint during a home invasion robbery late last night. Her three children were home at the time. Three suspects remain on the loose. KTLA's Erin Myers has the latest on the investigation.
Hi, you two. A really frightening situation. This woman was at home with her three children when three suspects somehow got inside and they held that woman at gunpoint. Now, it happened across the street here in that apartment complex located on the 2000 block of North Beverly Plaza, not far from Garford Street. We'll go ahead and get into some video from last night. You can see crime scene investigators walking through the area along with several police vehicles parked outside. Drones could also be seen flying overhead helping with this investigation. We're told Long Beach police responded around 11 last night to this home invasion robbery. Investigators say a man entered the residence where this mother and her three children were. The suspect held the woman at gunpoint while two other men ransacked the residence, according to police. The suspects then fled the scene with items from the apartment. Exactly what was taken isn't known at this time. We have reached out to investigators for more information on what was stolen. As for the suspects, there is not a detailed description of them, just that they were adults. And there are no reports of other apartment units being robbed, so we are trying to get more information on if this specific unit was targeted for some reason or if police think that it was random. And though this was a terrifying situation, fortunately that mother and her children, they were not hurt in this incident. Anyone with any information is encouraged to contact the Long Beach Police Department. Reporting here in Long Beach, I'm Erin Myers, KTLA 5 News.
Developing news here, the FBI investigating power outages in North Carolina as a criminal act. Agents say someone opened fire on two power substations in Moore County Saturday night. As a result, 45,000 people lost power over the weekend amid freezing temperatures. Officials announced a state of emergency that included a curfew through this morning. Duke Energy says the repairs could take days. The FBI is looking for the suspect or suspects. It's unclear why someone would open fire on power stations. Governor Gavin Newsom will convene a special legislative session today on gas prices.
Governor wants major oil companies to face what he calls a price gouging penalty after Californians paid record high prices over the summer. KTLA's Eric Spillman in the newsroom with more on that. Eric, good morning.
Morning, Frank. Good morning, Jessica. Governor Newsom has spent the last several months railing against the oil companies. He says they're fleecing consumers. And so today he's called the legislature into special session to go after big oil.
Oil executives, these companies, they're lining their own pockets by ripping off Californians at the pump. And they should put some of that money back in your pockets.
Newsom says in just 90 days this fall, oil companies raked in profits of $63 billion, and he says they did it by overcharging California drivers for gas. Who can forget what we were paying just a few months ago when gas prices spiked to an average of $6.43 a gallon here in California? At one point this fall, we were shelling out $2.60 a gallon more than the average price in the rest of the country. The oil companies blamed the higher fuel prices on refinery maintenance issues. They have relatively few refineries in California, and they say it's expensive to operate here. But Newsom says they're just greedy. His office releasing these figures showing how much money big oil made in the third quarter of this year. Examples: Phillips 66 made a profit of more than $5 billion. Chevron raked in 11.